If you have a classic American guitar, either acoustic or electric, chances are that it came with Kluson Deluxe tuners, whether they are vintage originals or contemporary replicas. It has been said you either love Klusons or hate them, but before we take sides, are we sure that we really know them? We are just about to see the structure and identify the different types. Also, we are examining the variations through the years for an accurate dating. Then we are individuating the different reissues. And finally, I'm giving you a few useful technical tips to get the best out of your vintage style tuners. BTR number 38, Kluson Deluxe Tuners. Review, dating and history. In the old pictures of our guitar heroes, we see that the most frequent modification that they made to their Gibsons and Fenders was changing the hardware. In particular, the original Kluson tuners were regularly swapped with the bulkier Grover Grotomatics. With this in mind, when I was 20, my guitar tech friend told me that the Kluson tuners on my vintage 60s Telecaster were worn out. He advised that if I wanted to gig with trustworthy tuners, I had to change them. Following this advice, I went to a music store in Rome and asked for a drop-in replacement set for my Kluson tuners. They showed me a box of reproductions by Schaller. I remember that I watched this box and I realized that I just didn't want to change my Kluson. I gave back the Schaller box to the clerk and went away. Today I can say that I made a wise decision. My guitar tech had made a wrong assumption. I happily used those original Kluson tuners on my Telecaster for hundreds of gigs in the following 30 years. They were still in perfect shape when I recently sold the guitar. I would say that the thin and weak appearance of the lightweight original Kluson tuners is deceptive. Although they are not as sturdy and responsive as old Grovers, still they were excellent quality tuners. But are Kluson tuners all the same? Let's start from the beginning. The original company was founded in Chicago by John Edward Kluson in 1925 and began its activity as a machine shop. By the mid-1930s, John Kluson had found an interesting empty market niche, producing hardware for stringed instruments. His business evolved into an established factory. During the golden age of guitar manufacturing, until the late 1960s, Kluson became the major supplier of American music industry, of tuning machines, tailpieces, bushings and other metal components. Harmony, Supro, Gibson, Epiphone, Fender, Martin, Guild, Kay, Moss Wright, Dan Electro and Rickenbacker all mounted Kluson tuning pegs as OEM, Original Equipment Manufacturer Parts. By the mid-70s, Kluson had lost the most important customers. In fact, Fender and Gibson ended up changing supplier, adopting German-made Schaller tuning machines. This affected the destiny of Kluson. In the early 80s, the company quietly left the scene, leaving behind little or no historical information and documentation of the past activity. The more sought-after types of Klusons are the deluxe tuners with closed back, mounted on the most valuable Gibson and Fender models. The basic elements of these tuners are tip or button, tuner shaft with worm drive, which is the most delicate part, gear wheel, base plate, string post, mounted through the bushing, and gear cover or enclosure. For neophytes, with few exceptions, Fender used 6 keys in line, and Gibson generally used sets with 3 keys on a side. On their less prestigious instruments, Gibson used sets with 3 tuners mounted on a single plate for each side, with plastic round buttons. Some low-priced guitars of various brands had all 6 keys mounted in line on a strip or single bass plate, with reduced post spacing. Upmarket Gibson models sport the distinctive plastic buttons with tulip or keystone shape, while Fenders generally adopts the metal round buttons. Leo Fender designed for his guitars the exclusive safety post, which had a slot and a hole through the center, intended to secure and safeguard the sharp cut end of the string. If we examine the variations of some features through the years, we can pinpoint a few common guidelines for a correct dating of all these different versions of Kluson Deluxe tuners. The following section is a reference to define the period of manufacture of original Kluson Deluxe tuners on vintage guitars. The earliest Kluson Deluxe tuners, produced from 1947 to 1951, could be referred to as sealed branded tuners. Actually, they are far from being sealed. Their nickname is due to their closed enclosure. The end of the worm shaft is still fully closed inside the gear cover and does not protrude through the side. The gear cover sports the company's brand and the model name on a single line at the center, saying Kluson Deluxe. The keystone or tulip-shaped plastic tips on Gibson tuners have a single decorative ring at the base. This early version presents a patent-applied stamping on the bottom face of the gear cover. When you remove the tuner, the patent-applied lettering is also stamped on the back of the base plate, along with the 7-digit number. This lettering remained unchanged until the patent was awarded in late 1958. In early 1952, the Kluson Deluxe lettering and the patent-applied stamping were removed from the cover, still fully closed. This transitional version, which remained in use for about 1 year, could be named Sealed No Brand. In 1953, a hole is open on one side of the gear casing, so the end of the worm shaft now protrudes through the enclosure. These tuners remained in use until mid-1956 and are generally referred to as no brand or no line. The Kluson Deluxe lettering at the center reappeared in 1956, so this further variation is named the single brand or single line. The keystone tips still have a single ring at the base, so Gibson tuners from this period are nicknamed single line, single ring. In late 1958, the patent was finally granted, so a patent number starting with the letter D is now stamped into the metal on the back of the base plate. These tuners, otherwise identical to the previous version, are hence commonly referred to as single-line D patent number. A new version of the keystone or tulip buttons arrives in 1960. They now have 2 decorative rings molded at the base, so the Kluson tuners made for Gibson between 1960 and 1964 are named single-line double ring. As you can see, these single ring buttons from 1959 are deteriorated. Being a guitar player, I'm not the most reliable source for polymer chemistry, but from my understanding, the early unstable celluloid plastic of the 1950s used organic resins or additives. As a result, certain batches of plastic buttons from those years tend to biodegrade with age. They become brownish, shrink, and eventually crumble over time, especially when closed for a long time in a case. The tulip tips from the late 50s are particularly vulnerable. This problem was definitely solved in 1961 with the formulation of stable plastic mixture. In late 1964, the Kluson brand and the Deluxe name were split into two separate lines. This type of tuning keys, referred to as double line or double brand, remained in use on Gibson guitars until 1969, when the brand stamped on the first line was changed from Kluson to Gibson. These tuners with Gibson brand, still made by Kluson, were discontinued in the mid-1970s. Fender had stopped using the double brand Klusons in 1967, when they switched to tuners produced in-house. After 1975, Fender again outsourced the production of their tuners, which was contracted out to Schaller in West Germany. I believe that Kluson continued to produce double line keys as Fender replacement parts for a few years. This is one of the latest original American-made Klusons. It does not have the D-patent stamp on the back of the base plate. What happened after the original Kluson manufacturing company closed its doors? Let's imagine that I'm a millionaire, if I can ask for a big stretch of the imagination. Let's figure that a historic brand, for instance Rickenbacker, shuts down. I could buy the brand and set new facilities near my home in Italy, or contract out the production to third parties elsewhere. Would you trust my products? Would you consider my guitars real Rickenbackers? The answer is simple. If I manage to build high-quality products, faithful to the original instruments, I will probably live up to the good name of the original company. On the contrary, you will consider my products low-grade copies and miss the originals. This actually happened to many historic brands of the music industries. Kluson is a typical example. The Kluson brand was resumed in 1993 by Larry Davis of WD Music Products, a distributor of guitars and parts based in Florida. The Kluson branded tuning machines by WD are manufactured in Korea. This is a set of WD reproductions. And this is an original Kluson set from the 50s. Judge yourself which one would you trust more. You don't have to be an expert. In 1999, the German guitar parts dealer Goldo found that the Kluson trademark was free for the European market. So they registered the brand and owned the rights to use the name in Europe. Kluson replicas by Goldo are made in Japan by Goto and are virtually identical to the tuners with Gibson brand mounted on the custom shop vintage reissues in the 2000s, which are high quality. Gibson then switched to the tuners with Kluson brand produced by WD. On my 335 from 2014, I found this set. They even have thinner posts and need a special thicker bushing to fit vintage regular post holes. I chose to replace them with vintage original Klusons. Vintage Klusons have a gear ratio of 14 to 1. This means that the string post does a complete turn every 14 turns of the tuning peg. Reissues often advertise, trumpets up, that they have higher improved gear ratio over vintage originals. Actually, this is another myth to debunk. A higher gear ratio doesn't necessarily mean better tuners. A higher ratio allows a finer tuning, but also involves more friction and more turns to get the string to pitch. With a lower gear ratio, you need less turns to get the same effect on tuning. So the ideal ratio is a reasonable compromise between precision and quick and smooth operation. Quality manufacture is hence more important than ratio. Please note that for proper tuning stability with Kluson type tuners, you want to tune up to pitch rather than down to pitch. If the pitch is sharp, you have to tune down below pitch and then retune up. Furthermore, it's fundamental a correct string winding with only a few wraps around the posts. In conclusion, I've been waiting the whole video to crack this joke. A couple of tricks to get the best out of your vintage style tuners and save yourself unnecessary tuner replacements. Please bear in mind that if your guitar does not stay in tune, most of the tuning issues are due to friction. Before spending money on new tuners, let an expert luthier check out the nut slots. Also, a good maintenance can avoid problems. You have noticed, for sure, a round hole in the gear casing. All Kluson Deluxe casings have it, besides some early prototypes. Sometimes the hole is very small, sometimes it's a bit larger. It is intended to lubricate the gear mechanism inside the casing. Quality lubricating oil or lithium grease are some of the most precious yet undervalued allies of the guitar player. I don't know many players who regularly lubricate their guitar's hardware. This simple operation has huge benefits on the longevity of the strings and on the efficiency of the hardware. More about this in a future BTR episode. If the old buttons shrink and fall apart, don't throw those vintage Kluson tuners away. Buttons can be replaced. There are a few options on the market. If you are lucky enough to find them, all vintage enthusiasts agree that Uncle Lou's buttons made by Lou Gattanas are the best reproductions. They preserve the authentic looking opalescence of the originals while ensuring lifelong duration. Even collectors consider them better than crumbling original tips. Bottom line, don't let anyone tell you that your old Kluson tuners are worn out junk. Don't forget to subscribe and click the bell to keep in touch. Please remember to let me know your thoughts in the comments below. Feel free to join our Facebook group and visit the BTR Instagram profile.